In this demonstration, I'm going to measure the phase noise of a 100 MHz oven-controlled crystal oscillator using the Holzworth HA7062D phase noise analyzer. The first thing I'm going to do is connect to the analyzer. So I have successfully connected. Now this OCXO requires a supply voltage and a tune voltage. So if I go to the Outputs tab, I can put in a supply voltage, here I've put in 12, and a tune voltage, here I've put in 5. Both of these voltages are supplied directly from the phase noise analyzer. The next thing I want to do is set up the type of measurement I want to make. So I want to make an absolute phase noise measurement, but you can see I have a number of other options to choose from. Additive phase noise, baseband, amplitude noise, and AM/PM. I want to use cross correlation, and for my initial measurement I will just use one correlation, and I've selected the offsets to be from 100 Hz to 100 MHz. So let's make our measurement. So here's our first phase noise measurement on the oscillator. The shaded area underneath here is the approximated noise floor of the phase noise analyzer. And you can see that my phase noise measurement is fairly close to this noise floor. So to get greater certainty in the measurement, I can increase the number of correlations to get some correlation gain and get more separation from the measurement and the noise floor. So I will go here and I will pick 10 correlations. And we'll make another measurement. So even with 10 correlations, you can see it's very fast. And also, you should have noticed that the approximated noise floor has been reduced, which gives me a greater margin between the noise floor and the measurement itself, which gives me more certainty in the measurement that I'm making. And one thing I notice is my DUT has a number of spurs, and I'm really just focusing on the phase noise. So I have the ability to go in and remove any spurs above a certain threshold. So in this case, it's 5 dB. So let's put on remove spurs. And you can see in the resulting trace, those spurs that were there before have now been successfully removed. The signal is still fairly noisy. If I want to get a little clearer picture of the phase noise, I can add smoothing. Going back into my trace tab, I can turn smoothing on. Let's acquire again. Now if I focus on that particular trace, you can see I have a nice smooth plot of the phase noise of this oscillator. So by default, the display has markers at the decade offsets, but if I wanted to put in my own markers, I have the ability to do that. I put in some markers ahead of time. Let me just turn them on. Now if we go back to trace one, you can see that I've put markers on the peaks of the spurs. Now the spur measurement values that are provided are in dBc per hertz. If I'd like to see those as a spectrum analyzer would see them, I can choose to scale them to dBc. So I'll put those back to normal. And now that I'm done with my measurements, I can export this plot as a PNG file. And you saw the snapshot it did of the plot itself. Or I can go in and I can export or generate a complete report. So if I expand this, you can see it better. I have my phase noise measurements, all four traces, and then I have all the details behind each of the traces. And this allows me to get a complete report and a full phase noise analysis of my OCXO.